And are there any differences in healing of bone fractures or any other conditions about bone, such as process of aging?
ありがとうございます。素晴らしい活動だと思います。
Thank you very much. That's a wonderful activity. As you know, in space, we do not have great gravity, so our bones deteriorate. But what's good about the space is that we do not need to walk. So if we just push the wall, we can just move around. But in order to prevent weakening of bones, we do exercise, like push up, using barbells or squats, and in those activities we may tend to have injuries. And, I actually have never heard of anyone who had fracture in space, so to be frank, I do not know what would be the healing with the bones. But when I think about the condition of recovery of fracture, the fractured bone have to be in right position, and the blood flow has to be right, and no force is applied that those bones do not go apart. So when you think about in space, we do not need to walk, so you can be still, so we may have advantage there. But we also have to think about the cells that develops bones and also destroys cells. So that kind of very detailed genetic level research would be needed. Thank you very much. Now, next question, please. Good evening. I am from Ushiku City Active Exercise Promoter, Emiko Sasaki. And probably this is the silliest question that I'm going to ask today. I would like to ask about the disease under stress. So I would think that your life there is in very confined space, and you're living in zero gravity. So I would assume that you would be under stress. So how do you manage your stress? If you could share with us your experience, that would be very helpful. Thank you.
とんでもないです。良い質問だと思います。実際宇宙ステーションで、
Well, that's not true. This is not a silly question at all. It's a very good question. In reality, in space station, it is like you are in your camping out with your best colleagues. So we are not too much under stress. However, if I may say exercising or discuss having good talk with your colleague and look out from the window and see the earth and take pictures and listen to music. So those are what I do if I feel stressed. Thank you very much for a good question. Now we have Mayor of Ichihara, Mayor of Tsukuba, Mr. Ichihara, Mayor of Tsukuba City, and I'm also representative of Tsukuba Ikiki Exercise Class. And as a mayor, I am very happy that Dr. Furukawa is doing so well. We are very proud of your activity, and especially space development and scientific results, and also very precious experience of Dr. Furukawa would be utilized in the future. So I hold a very high expectation of your work. So my question is, as a strategy to take action for aging society, the health of elderly is very important. And so in order to make a good society where elderly can live healthily, I wonder how your activities or experiments would be utilize in our activity on Earth. Thank you very much for your wonderful questions. I would like to explain from two perspectives. One is, if I take one example, right next to here, about 3 meters away from the camera, we have protein growth crystal growth experiments, and this is a good environment to grow crystal. And this is a protein that is supposed to cure cancer, and our colleague is going to go back to Earth with that result. And by analyzing the result, we would be able to see the three-dimensional structure of the protein. So this is going to be a very effective way to develop a new medicine. So that's one way to contribute to make the life on Earth better. And the second is utilizing our own body as the subject of experiment, for example. Taking medicine for osteoporosis in preventive manner, so we are subject to ourselves, so that the such result will be utilized and would be the preparation for the time when anyone can go to this place. Thank you very much for a good question. Thank you very much. Next question, please. Good evening, Dr. Furukawa. We are from Kawasaki and from Keiwakai, and we have various departments in our hospital, like the orthopedics and also dentist. And we heard that there are similarities to aging of bones and influences that happen in space. And what do you think is important to keep yourself from aging physically? Anything about your meals, supplements, training, or mental things? Well, probably I should learn from you, but if I may, I would like to share what we are doing. And we, regarding meals, we try to have good balance and try to take as much possible vegetables and fish. And in space, vitamin D is very important. On the ground, vitamin D is activated when you're exposed to the sun, but that is difficult in this environment, and that is why we take more vitamin D. And we do exercise every day. And we try to make it not so monotonous, to try to do things differently every day. And also we try to numerical target, like how many times you could do squats. And by looking at the variation, you see that you're improving. Thank you very much for your question. Thank you very much. Next question, please. I am from Preventive Medicine for Elderly Association. I am Masayoshi Honda, and we are the group that promotes the preventive measures, and I am in charge of oral care, so I would like to ask about the swallowing. And on the ground, we have gravity to support us when we swallow. So without the support of gravity in space, do you have difficulty swallowing down food in space? And also, do you feel any changes when you went up to space for the first time compared to now, such as choking or difference in swallowing down food? Thank you very much for a very good medical question. Regarding swallowing, actually it is much smoother compared to what I had expected. Probably that's because of the liquid content. When water exists as it is, it becomes globe, but when it is attached to some surface, it spreads. Just like case that when you have saliva, the food spreads. So when the food is together with fluid, liquid, it goes very smoothly. So swallowing is not so difficult, but when you take medicine, and if you do that, if you take medicine with a little water, it may sometimes be difficult. So it's actually fairly smooth. The swallowing is fairly smooth. And regarding the change of body, the body fluid shifted upwards. So I was had a headache and a moon face at the very beginning, but I got quite accustomed to the life here, and so I do not feel so heavy at all. And I think that my moon face has improved a little bit, I think. I'm from Tatebayashi. I'm from KU Fracture Prevention Medicine Center. And as a person who looks at the safety of the local community, we do activity to promote health in the area, and I'm Kuramochi Masai. So my question is, it is difficult to walk when you feel the pain in your knees and back, and I would think it's difficult to develop your bones with walking in space. Do you have any advice to develop your bones without walking?
はい、ありがとうございます。向井飛行士のご出身地からいらっしゃったんですね。
Thank you very much for the question. So you're from the same area as Dr. Mukai is from. And to be frank, it's rather difficult to strengthen your bones without walking. So some, in one way or the other, you have to stimulate your muscle. So when you have pain in knees or backs, it has to be, you have to continue moving, even if it is in a small manner. And even in space, we try to continue our exercise with less load compared to usual. Thank you very much. Next question, please. Good evening, Dr. Furukawa. I am from Adderley Locomotive Syndrome Research Center. We are the group of orthopedics, and we focus on the importance of exercise for elderly people. We hold very lectures and so on. So my question is, since lower legs get weaker slowly because of aging and loss of exercise, it's hard to feel the moderate deterioration of ourselves. So that progress very slowly. In your case, do you feel any differences with the loss of bone mass and muscles that takes place so dramatically in case of space?
はい、確かに知らない間に筋力が減っていくというのは怖いことですよね。
It is scary that you lose your muscle and bone mass without realizing. In our case, we are exercising. We do not feel that we are losing our muscle, and we are using our exercise machine and squatting and raising barbells, and so we are maintaining or actually increasing the muscle. But the one thing that's important, I think, is to look at numbers, numerical, how many times you push up and what's the weight. So by keeping a record numerically, it would be becomes more easy to recognize the loss of muscles or bone mass. Thank you very much for the question. We are of UNDA Sendai Miyagi. I am Kamiya. My question is, it is easy to get deep thrombophlebitis in space compared to being in space. Do you train yourself for soleus venous thrombus? And how does the milking action of beans change in zero gravity? And any actions to prevent that?
はい、専門的なご質問ありがとうございます。被災地の方もいろいろ大変な方がいらっしゃると思います。
Very medical question, and thank you very much. And I believe that a lot of people have difficulty in their disaster hit area. And in space, actually, fortunately, we do not have so much of, we are not sure whether we get the deep thrombophlebitis in space because we do not sit still and the blood flow will get worse if it doesn't happen. So we do not do any exercise for that purpose. And regarding milking, the venous blood comes back to the heart, so that movement takes place very similar on ground. So the zero gravity environment is working positive way, actually. But thank you very much for a very scientific question. Thank you. I am from, you are, I believe, from Yokohama, and I am from Yokohama, Health Promotion Activity Group, and I am Hideo Matsuzawa. My question is, I've watched an astronaut eating Japanese food. I've heard that the strength of muscles can get so much lower in space. And do you feel any changes in the power of chewing, or do you feel any change of texture of food? Thank you very much from my local town. Well, I don't think that the chewing power changes because the strength or the frequency of the chewing muscle does not change compared to the Earth. And regarding the texture, I personally do not feel any changes. And even if I talk with my colleague, there may be some change in the taste, like people tend to like spicy food more on space, and many other people say that they do not feel any change in taste either or texture either. But thank you very much for the good question. So this is going to be the last team. We are from Chuo Gakuen Welfare and Medicine College. My name is Toda. So my question is, if you are disabled and bedridden in the future, which would you choose, to live in space or here on Earth? And what's the reason for that?
はい、究極の質問ですね。お答えはやはり地球です。
Well, that's an ultimate question. Well, my answer to that is I prefer to live on Earth. Space is zero gravity. I don't need to walk. But in this current environment, it is like camping out. So you have to take care of yourself. Well, if you are to have welfare or the care facility in space, it might be a very good place to live. But currently, I prefer to live on Earth because I would like to feel the forest or ocean around. So that would be the wonderful thing about the Earth. But the view from the space is also very wonderful. So it would be very great if I can have both of the 3D view of the Earth and then live on ground. Well, Dr. Furukawa, your answers were really enjoyable answers. And thank you very much. And here with us are a lot of people who are working in healthcare and elderly care areas. So would you like to send a message to them?
はい、僭越なんですが申し上げさせていただきます。皆様のような年配の方々が
対する
意識が高いということで、その皆様方の
身体的、it is very important that you have very high consciousness about the importance of health, and I believe that your mental and mind condition would be more active, and that would make Japanese society more lively and wonderful, and which I think is very important. And I hope that more people would have high consciousness about the importance of health. And your experience is a treasure for us. So I hope that you will share, communicate with the younger generation as well, and give guidance to the younger generation too. Thank you very much for this opportunity to communicate with you. This concludes the event.